Hey, everybody. Oh, I got the best blades. Mine are wider. And, yes, they are the best blades.
No! Mine's the best blade. Mine is thinner and cuts the wind better. Makes less noise like you big bastard.
Well, yes, mine are rounded on the edge, but they are wider. They do catch the wind pretty good.
Well, mine catches the wind pretty good, but yet at higher RPMs, mine will make a better wall. Yes, because mine will get higher RPMs. They won't stall out.
Well, that's not true. That's not true at all. Mine are the fastest blades in the world.
No, they're not. Mine are. Oh, let's see what's new. I hear there's a new kid on the block. Oh, let's find it out. Hold on. Oh, gosh. Oh, ouch. Ouch. Eat. Wait a minute. Wait.
Hey. Mine is wider.
But mine is sharper. Okay, we know that now. Let's check out the new kid on the block.
Hey, everybody. This is the new kid on the block, kind of, sort of, in a way. I guess, you know, daddy old mom too on eBay. I want to tell you that these blades are awesome. The hub in itself is powder coated. It's five blade set here. They're 70 inches in sweep of the blade and are 34 inches long for just one single blade and 6 inches in width. Okay. And they're galvanized. That's what's awesome. You know, you don't even have to paint them unless you're like in a really bad salted air condition, whatever. So anyways, the 3 to 5 is what I look at startup, and that's for the 5 blade. Okay. And then we'll go right up here. Doop. And I want to show you this too. Once again, the 3 blade here costs $79.95. See the shipping, wasn't bad at all. Still $100 bill, big difference than paying out $200 for 11 blades or whatever they're charging, you know. Okay, and then we got the you got same sweep area, 70 inches, 34 inches in length, 6 inches wide, galvanized. You can paint these, but you want to make sure when you paint them, you do several thin coats. Don't get right up with your can of spray paint and then you're going to have running effect and all that. Just do thin coats, like multiple, probably at the most, I'd say, probably enough to cover it, which would be probably 2 to 3. Okay. Here we go. 7 mile an hour, 4 to 7 mile an hour startup, people. Can't beat that. But yeah, I just want to show you that real quick. And I'm going to show you some more. Be back. Well, I'm back, YouTube. And there they are. There are the Daddy Old Mom 2 blades. And man, are they big. Big blades. And just to show you, do a little walk up here. Here we got the Arex type style blades. But I want to talk about the bolt pattern real quick. I like that offset bolt pattern, because then it'll be able to handle the pounding that wind is going to put on there, and plus the torque. Okay, and then it's a lot different than what the two-hole mount is. Okay, and then we have the galvanized blade, people. Yeah, there it is. And then I like the airfoil too on these. Real nice airfoil. And then, you know, they're thin blade. Let's see, but Thermodynes are still thinner. They'll cut the wind a lot better. Let me get over here. There we go. It'll cut the wind a lot better. Okay. Of course, I got a little notch here. I must have dropped it. Sorry for all this jiggling around. This one, they kind of use like a lift to the blade, you know. But there it is. But, you know, there's this big war about blades and PMAs, and I think what it boils down to is not who makes the best, but who can work with everybody to try to make everybody in the RE community work together instead of fighting. I want to talk about too. I got to get back up here again. You got the three-blade hub. I'll be doing testing with that also. And it's powder coated. Beautiful job powder coating. And then too, I was going to tell you, oh, the hardware comes with it. You know, I don't have all of it in there. Of course, see, this is just to show you the five blade, and I'm going to put the three blade up first. I want to show you too these collar bearings. Now you put this like you're at your bottom bracket. You put this in before you put the bracket on top of the collar. What this is actually a bearing. Nice little bearing that Daddy and Mom is selling. This is a lot better than using friction-based nylon rings that are cut out and being sold. But I'll be talking about collars and whatnot here soon to let people know, okay, what to expect from it. But that's a good idea. Get two of these. Two of your collars, bam, you're good to go. You know, there won't be no friction. Put some white grease in there if you want. Go ahead and put that black grease, get it all over. Or put Vaseline in there. You'll be fine. And do your, you know, your yearly maintenance to check on them. Just don't let them sit up there. You got to check on your turbine. Make sure everything's tight, every nut and bolt, and everything's nice and tight. Everything's true. So, this is Billy. And I showed you the websites, showed you how much, and go check them out. Get back here a little bit. There you go. Daddy-O Moms. Thanks, Alan. Thanks for that, my Canadian buddy. And now, I want to talk about BreezeKind. I'll have a link to his testing that he's doing now on Thermodyne and Missouri Wind. But I have one thing to say. This is going out to every one of you that watch my videos. Why would you buy from any of these companies that don't have charts? Even if they're factual or not, I guess. You want the factual ones, but you know how they are. I've seen even the Chinese makers bump up their numbers. And I have Chinese turbines. But why would you buy from a company or companies that don't have wind charts for their AC motors or whatever? Why would you do that? Why would you go spend that kind of money in the hopes that you're going to see 2,000 watts or 1,600 watts or 38, 34, whatever? You know, that's a good question out there to you people. If it's not showing a chart, but it has to be a good chart, it has to be one that's tested, been tested, why would you go and buy from a company that doesn't have a chart? It's a good question, right? Okay, this is Billy. Have a good one, people. Got more to show. I'm really happy and enthused with what's going on in my life lately, and it's going to get even better. All right, people, have a good one.